Hey guys, Alan from Guitar World here with Jack Bates of the Smashing Pumpkins. We're here at one of the first shows of your tour, summer tour. And you've been nice enough to give us a little tour of your rig here.
What we've got, we will show. It's not, compared to Jeff's technical wizardry, it's a lot more simple. But yeah. I think for bass, less is more, in my opinion.
Yeah, so, okay.
Yeah. We just got two Ampeg SVT Classics. One is the main and one is just a backup. I've been using these amps for 4 years since I started playing with the Pumpkins. And it's literally, I mean, we're just plugging straight in. We don't have any pedals. We have no effects on the entire show. We just plug straight in and it sounds amazing. It's really warm, well-rounded bass tone. We drive the amp pretty hard to get a really nice sound out of it. And yeah, I love those amps, man. It's the same, even before I was playing with the Pumpkins, I'd always use Ampeg. And it's really cool now because I play Yamaha guitars, and now that Yamaha owns Ampeg, so it's like all one family, so it's cool.
That's cool, yeah. Fantastic. So are you using any wireless system?
No. We're all wired. I think sometimes wireless, it can mess with the tone and that kind of thing, so. It couldn't be any simpler, man. And we're just running a big cable. This little guy makes sure that signal stays balanced, even though obviously my where I plug in is pretty far away. But that's literally the only thing we have. Just really long Divine Noise cables. If I can give them a shout out.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, here we are. Looks like you got quite an arsenal here of bases.
Yes. These are all Yamaha BBs. It's the newer version of the classic BB, which is the BB734A. All seven of these basses and the one in the dressing room are all exactly the same. I made no modifications or anything to them, which for me, I said this to the Scott from Yamaha, it's like that might be the best advert for the guitars, is that we haven't had to change a thing. You could go and buy these in the shop tomorrow. That's how I'm using them. There's nothing crazy going on. Nothing's been changed. So the only reason we have so many is because there's so many tune-ins. So we tried to color code it just to keep it simple for me and my tech. So we've got the white one, which is in E standard, and then E flat, drop D, and C. But I also put a hip shot on this one because we play in C sharp. So rather than change guitars, I can just flick it down and we're in the right tuning. We got mono Doolittle straps, which are, I kind of wear my bass pretty low because I take after my dad.
And sorry, for people who don't know?
Yeah, Peter Hook from Joy Division and New Order.
Nice.
Who is famous for wearing his bass around his ankles. Yeah. So I don't quite go that low. But these are really long and it's cool to be able to have that option. Mono have been great, sent us some great straps. And this one is a custom one that James actually bought me for Christmas, which is a Manchester United themed custom leather strap, which is made by a girl called Brittany from LA. And I thought, since we're out here on tour with Noel Gallagher, who's such a renowned Manchester City fan, I would do everything I could to try and hold up for the other side of Manchester.
Awesome.
So that's the only different thing in terms of the straps. But yeah, man, these basses are great. They're really consistent all across the fretboard. There's no dropout in the sound. They're really fun to play, really comfortable, really light as well, which is cool. And I just think they look super cool. I mean, I think Yamaha at the moment, they only make these two colors, which would be the matte black and the tobacco burst, I think they're calling it, rather than the sunburst. So I had to ask them really nicely to get white and red ones.
Okay.
But I'm trying to, because they look so cool, and the Yamaha guy agrees with me that we should try and get them to roll those out just to get a few more options for people.
Color-wise. So there might actually be a Jack Bates signature.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
It would have to have the hip shot on there too.
Yeah, well, I think my dad's going to get a signature bass way before I am. I got a long way to go, but yeah, we'll see. Yeah, so this is my white one, which they very kindly made for me. The only thing that's different with it is the color. Everything else is exactly the same. And I added a Hot One sticker because I'm desperate to go on that show. So if anyone is watching, please give me a call. Yeah, and this is the red one. Again, the only thing that's different is the color. I had to ask him very, very nicely. The idea was to try and get as close as we could to the color of the old school Yamaha BB, which is the 1200S, which is the one sort of made famous by my old man. So it was cool. We really nailed the color-wise. It looks great. And I suppose the one thing which is major that I forgot to talk about is that the best thing about these is the passive and active, because it gives you a whole range of different sounds out of the same guitar. So with the Pumpkins, we play the whole set on passive. But with these same guitars, I could then just literally at the flick of a switch go play with my dad, for which you would need a super bright bass tone, because we use chorus pedals and, you know, that's sort of his signature sound. But literally, like, you could play both bands with all these guitars, which is what's great. So,
well, Jack, thank you so much for showing this to us.
No problem.
I think you've proven sometimes simple is the way to go. Simple is better.
Hashtag less is more.
Less is more. That's it. And have a great tour. Everybody go see the Smashing Pumpkins.
Come see us.